Hey guys, it's Kim here and welcome back to my top 5 game of the year feature. And today's victim of choice is none other than the infamous, the legendary Mr. Sips. How you doing, Sips?
Woo!
Hi. Hi. Cheering. Hi.
Hooray.
Hi. Why am I a victim? I thought this was going to be fun. You said
not yet.
You said this was going to be like a fun thing.
Definitely going to be fun. Definitely going to be fun.
Okay.
Yeah, no secret things going on behind the scenes. Nothing at all.
Okay, I trust you.
Yeah, do that. Just like I trusted you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We got issues unresolved right off the bat.
Issues.
Sorry about that. Yeah.
Shall we jump straight into it? Oh, what is number 5 on your list of 5 to 1? What is your 5th game of this year?
Okay. 5th game for me of this year, even though I'm not even sure if it was released this year, is Dishonored.
Okay.
Was it released this year?
No.
Almost? It was almost released this year. Come on, Kim.
They had DLC this year.
Throw me a bone.
They had DLC, so that is the bone that I am throwing
you. That's how it counts. All right. Well, I mean, out of all the games I played this year, I probably played that one, well, I won't say the most because that's a blatant lie because I play a lot of WoW, but it was really, really, really good. And I know I made videos on it and stuff too, but I made videos on it because it's so good. I just thought it was amazing.
Yeah.
It got a bad rap, didn't it?
Did it?
Dishonored. Like
I
a lot
loved
of people.
It.
Yeah. A lot of people loved it, but then equally, quite a few people did not love it. There was no love.
Who are these people? Should we go find them?
I don't know who they are. I don't know what they are.
Yeah.
But I want them to all know that they're wrong.
Yeah.
It's a great game. They're categorically
wrong.
They've
clearly got issues in life.
I know. I just thought it was. I liked the art style. I thought it was amazing. Like all the costumes on the guards and stuff like that was really cool. Setting was really cool. The voice acting was superb. The story, like the backstory and everything, was awesome. It was just really great. I like how you can play however you want to. Like I played the first without any of the DLC. The first time I played it like super stealthy. I barely killed anyone. I wanted to be like undetected and everything. And then like I played it again.
So like low chaos.
Yeah. And then I played it again right after, and I played high chaos, and I was like chucking grenades like right in people's faces and stuff. I was just like going toe to toe with them and everything.
Yeah.
And I just thought it's great. I mean, for what you actually pay for and everything, you almost effectively get 2 games because of the like completely different play style. Different actions lead to different consequences. There's like slight changes in the story and stuff like that. I just thought it was really, really good. I almost swore there too to emphasize how good, but I didn't, Kim.
Already with the swears.
I did it for Christmas.
for Christmas. For the children
I did
at
it
Christmas.
For Christmas. That's right, yeah. Yeah. So
Yeah,
the base game Dishonored, and I still haven't played the second DLC, the second like story DLC,
because
there's other DLC for it, isn't there? There's two like main story continuation DLCs, and then there's like that sort of Trials of SimCity or whatever it's called, the one where you have to like, you got to do a lot of parkour with magic parkour.
Like that?
Yeah.
My most dreaded,
because normal
of all
parkour
words.
does not use magic. But sometimes when I'm watching it, I think these people must be using magic.
Yeah, it looks like magic. You know, slight
so
witchiness
incredible.
There.
Yeah.
Like Featherfoot or something like that.
It is. Featherfoot. That's not... Witches don't need to use that. They already have, like, hideously deformed feet that make no sounds anyway when they shuffle along.
Yeah?
That's the rope that you can hear.
Okay.
Yeah, it trails on the ground.
Right.
It makes a sound. It's not their feet. I don't even think they have feet. They just have stumps, and they just sort of like glide around. They have to lube up the stumps, so that they can, you know, they don't like tear all the skin off the bottom.
They have to lube it up with like bat's blood or something.
No, come on, what are you talking about? That's not suitable lubricant.
What would be a suitable
Vaseline's
lubricant
fine,
then?
Kim.
Vaseline, okay.
KY jelly, KY jelly will do it.
For the modern day witch.
Yeah, for the modern day witch. Yeah, for
so
some gliding.
So the modern day witch has no feet, has just stumps that they have to lube up with KY jelly while they do some magic parkour.
Yeah, for Christmas, just for you. Just this Christmas. That's, you wake up Christmas morning, that's the first thing you're going to think of. Looped
oh
up stumps.
Hey kid, you been naughty this Christmas?
Oh no, you gotta lick the stump 10 times. That's your punishment. No!
Oh, no!
No! what? It's just a, it's a leg stump. It's fine. It's not perverted or anything. Come on. It could have been worse. Could have been worse.
This sounds like the worst Christmas ever.
it's gearing up to be the worst one, I think, actually, after this conversation.
Yeah.
We can maybe bring it back, but who knows. Okay, all right, should I move on to number four?
Yes, let's go on to number four very quickly.
Okay, number four for me, controversially, I don't know if many people will agree with this, but for me personally, I really enjoyed the new SimCity, even though a lot of people said it was garbage it was released too quickly and there was a lot of problems with the constantly...
It was quite broken.
It was really broken. But they fixed it all, more or less. And the new DLC is out. Cities of Tomorrow DLC is out. And that is excellent too. I mean, the thing is, I was really looking forward to SimCity because I was a huge fan of the previous games. And it was when I went to Gamescom, I got to play the new SimCity. And that made me like really excited because of all the changes they made, you know, with the buildings. You plop down the buildings and then each building has like plot points within the buildings and everything. I thought that was all really cool. And I just really like the pace of, you know, sitting around and planning out a city and making the big ones and all that kind of stuff. And I thought it was great. I wasn't expecting too much from it because, you know, Maxis isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
And EA, I guess, are just like
evil.
Some like evil corporation that nobody likes. but actually, I was pleasantly surprised. I really was, actually, and I really enjoyed it. And I'm still excited to play it, and I really like the DLC. The Cities of Tomorrow DLC is really cool. A lot of the new buildings and stuff that they've added in are really awesome. Like the mega towers and stuff are really great. It's just really good. I'd say that it's definitely my number four of 2013.
Wow.
What do you think of that, Kim?
That is.
You angry
fine.
Now?
Are you
mad?
Why would I be mad? Why would I be mad?
I don't know.
This is a free
opinion forum. I just was hoping
forum,
that maybe...
You know, I'm not going to get...
You know, maybe I thought maybe I could like derail this so much that you would just get so angry and scream at me and then we wouldn't even get to number three.
But... I'm not going to get mad at you, Sips. I'm not going to, you know, judge you for how you choose to lead your life. Like, that's not me. That's not
really?
My kind of, you know, persona. I'm a pretty easygoing gal, you know?
Okay, Kim.
If you want to put SimCity in at number four, you can put SimCity in at number four.
Okay, can I change it around at the last second to number one?
No.
Okay.
So, without further ado, what is number three?
Well, I was going to go on to 4A, because of the categories now, so...
But...
Okay, fine, I'll do three.
No, okay.
Three for me is a game from 2011, is that allowed?
Okay, yes, no.
Come on, it's, no, I've played it. I've played it all year, Kim. I should be allowed.
Okay.
Allow
for
me.
For you, Sips, for you.
Okay. My number three, then, is Skyrim from 2011. Hey!
You're so current.
Oh, come on, I've played it.
You're so current.
I know, I'm totally up to date. I'm just totally up to date. So, Skyrim, I've been playing this year because I finally got a chance to pick it up. I started playing it in February this year, Kim. And I've really played a lot of Skyrim actually,
yes,
and I've really enjoyed it too.
You definitely have.
I've enjoyed every minute of it. I just love those sort of open world games where you can get quests and stuff. Like, it's cool because you can do anything you like, but you can sort of stick to some sort of path as well. You know,
yeah.
If you actually want to just get through the quests and like and do the story and stuff, you can. If you don't want to do any of that stuff, you don't have to. You could just get on a horse and you could just get out
just
there
ride.
And live your life. You can live live free
as a
and
lizard
live hard.
Bitch.
As a lizard and a prostitute if you want, or maybe you can uphold like the holy law of whatever his name is. Like, I'm so bad. I've played this game for a year.
Yeah,
I still
yeah.
don't know like anything about
what
it.
What on earth you're
like,
doing?
I don't know any of the guys, what they're doing or anything, but it's fun. It is fun. I like, you can really customize your character. I feel you can make stuff work for you. You know, there's probably like some fairly sort of like cookie cutter builds out there, like, you know, people who min-max and stuff like that. But I'm happy. I'm happy just playing the game the way that I would like to just play it. That's like how I would have played it in private as well.
Yeah.
I would have just dicked around a lot. I would have tried to like find like all these hidden caves and meet all these different people and stuff. That's how I played Fallout and stuff too. Just really, really enjoy the pace. I like adventuring and exploring and stuff
like
that.
Putting buckets
on
people's
heads.
For me,
Skyrim has just been Absolutely. Yeah, you've got to have a call sign. It's like in Home Alone. You know when they left the sinks running?
Yeah, because they were the wet hand gang.
The wet hand gang, that's right. Yeah, and they got those paint cans in the face for it. There's always a consequence to leaving a call sign. But in my case, I don't think there are paint cans.
Yeah, you're pretty consequence-free so far.
I think so far I've gotten away with it, yes.
Well, Uthgard gives you some pretty disapproving looks every now and again.
Yeah, but come on. I mean, nobody takes her seriously. Like, she's just like her.
I take her
seriously. Her bark is much worse than her bite.
I like Uthgard.
Yeah, well, she's very serious.
I'd like to shake her by the
hand. And the only way to befriend her, I think she would try to wring your neck because I think she likes to have a brawl with people first before she gets to know them.
I could do that.
Or that's like part of her way of getting to know people.
She I can do a mean pile driver, so, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
She's big. I mean, she's pretty big, Kim.
So,
no offense, but like, you're not very big.
I've been a short person all my life. You know, you learn how to fight. You learn how to take big people down.
Yeah, no, but this isn't just your everyday big person. She's also wearing like tons of plate armor too, which weighs a lot. I don't know if you've ever encountered an opponent in the ring that's been wearing plate armor before, but I imagine that would be fairly awkward to pile drive somebody wearing that much armor. Actually.
Plate armor has weak points, like, you know, the joint behind the knees, like that, you know, that's a very weak point. You know, I could take her down that way.
It's a weak point, but for a pile driver, you have to get your arms right around their waist, and Uthgard is built like a brick shithouse. She's square. She's not even... You have to get all the way around that, and also flip her upside down, and then,
good point.
Slam her head into the mat, into the canvas. I don't know if you could do it.
I reckon I could.
I'd pay big money, though, to see it.
Yeah, I reckon I could. I'd have a good go. I'd have a good old go at it.
A good old-fashioned try at the pile driver on the fantasy woman wearing plate armor.
Yeah. the five-foot girl versus the plate armor warrior.
Versus, she's got to be... How tall do you think she is? Like, if she was in real life, do you think she'd be 9 feet tall? Because I always imagine nine feet tall.
I was going to say she's more around, like, seven.
Seven's still...
Everyone's tall to me, so I don't really know what tall is. Like, you know, for me, there's variants
seven
of tall.
7 feet, yeah.
There's, like, tall.
Seven feet's a bit grotesque, though, isn't it? It's, like, a bit too tall. I think, like, if you're, like, 6'4", 6'4" is the max, really. I think if you're any taller than 6'4", you need to get that thing where they, like, they do that bone surgery on you and bring you down a couple inches.
Squish you a bit.
Too tall.
The Squishinator.
It's too much. Otherwise, join the NBA and do some dunks.
Yeah.
Because you don't even need to jump when you're that tall.
Yeah, just walk stroll up. Just strut up to the net.
Place the ball into the hoop. Yeah, you're done. Man, Jesus. What was this? Is this number three?
Skyrim,
are we still on number three?
Number three. That was three.
Okay.
So do you think you're going to be playing Skyrim forever and ever and ever and ever until, like, the end of time?
Until I get bored of it, yeah. I'm not, like, totally bored of it. The problem is I don't play it, like, I don't play it constantly throughout the week. Like, I play it in bursts to record it and then edit it, so... It's almost like coming back to a new game every time because I leave so much time in between sessions. So that's why I haven't gotten, like, too bored of it yet.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm always, like, excited to get back because I've forgotten where I was or what I was doing, and then it all comes back to me, and then it's like, well, hey, it's like a new game. So, so far, so good. Yeah.
Okay.
Who knows?
Maybe
the whole series will be like 500 episodes in the end.
Gosh.
I'm almost through Dawnguard now, I think.
Yeah.
Or maybe I'm not. Right.
So that was number three.
Yeah.
So shall we move on to number two?
Number two is going to be a bit of a weird one.
Okay.
I've been playing it a lot, though, Kim, and I mentioned it before we started, and it technically is 2013, but it's in Family and Friends beta at the moment.
Okay.
my number two, Kim, is going to be Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls because it's going to be... Awesome. Mark my words, going to be really good. They've made a lot of really good changes. It's going to be probably out in like 2016 because it's Blizzard, but I got to play the beta in 2013 and that's what matters for this. But it's good.
Okay, you know, just rubbing it in there.
It's good though. It's really good. I know you were saying that you didn't play Diablo because you were scared of ravens and stuff like that, and that's fine. I can respect that. I also find birds in general quite terrifying. Ravens are sinister too, but not as bad as seagulls are just annoying.
They're annoying.
Scary,
they're horrible.
They're just really frustrating and annoying creatures. But ravens, you wouldn't want to like meet one in a dark alley, especially one that was big.
They're quite smart, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. Yeah. And they have those like those camera lens eyes, you know, like they do that weird focusing thing and stuff.
It's and like, you know, they're like kind of seeing right through you. They're seeing into your soul and judging you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And also, I wouldn't want to meet one that was like a full-size raven, like a raven the size of me, for instance.
Okay.
I would not want to meet like a big...
Or like
a
songbird.
Big seagull I wouldn't have a problem with, because yeah. I just find them so annoying that despite their size, it wouldn't bug me. But a raven, already fairly scared of them. If I saw a giant one, I'd be even more scared.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't want to see like a really big one. But Reaper of Souls is really good so far. Like in the pre-beta, everything's tuned up. Like, so you get access to like a lot of the new features, like rifts. You just get like a million like rift shards, everything you kill, because they want you to get in there and test it and stuff like that. And that's kind of cool. But it's just such a cool idea. Like there's this whole new thing called adventure mode. So when you get past story mode, and I think this is gonna how it's gonna work, like when the game is released, because currently in the beta you can skip story mode. You don't even need to do the new act. You don't need to do act 1 through 4 or whatever. You can go straight into adventure mode, and everything scales to your level.
Sweet.
And the, like the whole adventure mode thing is just like the sort of, I think it's designed to be like the end game sort of grindy thing, but with objectives. So, you know, like you and your friends can jump in, and some of the rare creatures, especially like on expert mode and beyond, are really fucking hard. Like, I never saw this in Diablo 3, but like the rare creatures, they'll have like minions, which are just like as tough as they are and share the abilities. So like you just get like instantly fucking killed sometimes, like if they do like electrical charges and stuff like that. But I've just been playing the shit out of it. I cannot stop playing it. It's just so... they've introduced all this new stuff that's made it, like, really, really addictive.
Yeah.
But, like, it's all stuff that should have just been in Diablo 3, because if it was in Diablo 3, I'd still be playing it right now.
Yeah.
But I think Reaper of Souls, when it comes out, it's going to be really, really good. I think it's really sort of... There's a lot of stuff that reminds me of Diablo 2 and why I played Diablo 2 so much and why I love Diablo 2 so much. And I think they're really... like taking a nice step in the right direction to like get people back into the game and you know, keep people playing it. So there you go, Kim.
Wow.
That's my number two. Do you think, is that controversial for you? Do you find that controversial?
No, I don't find that controversial at all. Like, you know, you've made a very convincing case for why it's number two. Why would I hate you, Sips? Why would I hate you? Who could hate you?
Well, I've been trying like this whole time to like cause like some sort of stink or whatever, but
well, you've not been
not
doing
working.
Very
like if
well,
I said Bad
really?
Rats was my number one, would that be okay? Was Bad Rats released in like 2007 or something? I can't even remember.
Yeah, sure, whatever, you know. Like I said, I'm not, you know, I'm not here to judge you. I'm just here to find out more about you, Sips. You know, I'm not saying that your number one has to be like Bioshock Infinite or else I'm going to cut you, you know? That's not what I'm saying at all.
Oh, that's not my number one, though.
I didn't think it would be, no.
That's not my number one.
I think I know what your number one's going to be.
I don't think you know what my number one's going to be.
I don't know.
Guess what it is then.
Okay, I'm going to guess that it's going to be World of Warcraft, the new expansions like Siege of Orgrimmar and all that.
I do play it a lot. But I can't say that new patch has been my number one for 2013.
But you play it so much. Like, I've seen you.
I do play it a lot.
I've seen you.
I love it. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't... I wouldn't be talking to you right now if it wasn't for World of Warcraft. I play it a lot. I do play it a lot. But although I play it a lot, and although it is generally my favorite game to play... like the Siege, everything in 5.4 was really good and stuff like that, and I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed doing like the raids. I like LFR and all that. I like everything that they're doing with WoW, and I like the sound of everything that's going to be coming out in Warlords of Draenor as well.
Yeah.
It's going to be really, really good. It's really exciting. But it's not my number one, Kim.
Oh, okay.
It is not my number one. My number one, the game that I've had the most fun playing this entire year and that I can't praise enough is Hotline Miami. It's Hotline Miami.
Oh, nice. Nice choice.
It is the best game. It is so good. The music is so good. The gameplay is just so much. It's just a fucking fun game. It's not a long game. I was just sitting here screaming my head off for like hours. Yeah. I played the whole thing in one sitting pretty much. It was just amazing. I just loved every minute of it. I loved like having to retry sort of like tough corners, like with guys running at you and dogs and everything. And just the story was just so fucked up and weird. And just the whole game was It was just awesome. It was just, for me, it was just perfect. I can't wait for the sequel. It's going to be so good.
That's an amazing choice.
Oh, thanks, Kim.
Aww.
Well, I feel like I had so much fun playing it. It felt like a shame not to like include it.
But yeah, definitely.
Actually, of every game I played this year, that's definitely the one that just got me. It got me in. It just like sucked me in, and I played it like straight, and I had fun.
With the graphic violence.
The graphic violence. I mean, it's a shame because like games like Don't Starve and like Game Dev Tycoon and games like that where I've had a lot of fun as well. And I mean, I loved those, but like they're not top five for me. Like loved. But no, Hotline Miami was definitely just amazing. It was just really, really good. And I loved every minute of it. And I hope that the sequel is just as good. And I hope that they don't just sort of say, you know, Hotline Miami is amazing. Let's just, like, recycle all the really good parts of it. I hope they just go fucking crazy and just do, like, a whole bunch of new stuff that's just as awesome as the first one. Like, I just loved it, how it was so sort of random and violent and, like, obscene and stuff. And it was just great.
And quite challenging as well.
It was. Yeah, holy shit. My God, some, like, the boss encounters, like, the motorcycle helmet guy. Holy shit. My God, that took me forever. It was so hard. But it was just really good. It was really satisfying when you got him in the end. Yeah. And the guy that looked like Niles-y, too, with the machine guns. I don't know if you remember that. He was pretty fucking hard too, actually. But no, it was just really good. It was it's definitely my number one for this year. I really enjoyed it, and I can't wait for the next one. And I hope that the music and just everything, the style and everything of the sequel is going to be as good, if not better, than the first. Because wow, shit on 20 cats at the same time. That's crazy.
That would be your game of 2014 already.
Yeah, cat shitting simulator. That's got to be the sequel to Hotline Miami. Just a game about shitting on cats. I think they deserve it. Talking about ravens being sinister, what about cats? Cats are fucking crazy.
Yeah, where I live, like, there's so many. I've never lived anywhere that there are so many neighborhood cats. And there's one in particular. It's a white cat, long hair. But its face looks sinisterly human. Like, it has this really human face. And when it looks at you, I feel like I'm going to die. Like, it's just planning my death.
What, is it like a baby's face?
Yeah, it looks really, really human. And the other night, I went out in the dark to kind of take the rubbish out. And it was sat on the other side of the road. And it just looked at me. It turned and looked at me with such venom, like some kind of placid venom. I actually just stood there in the middle of the street just staring at it going, maybe if I don't make any sudden movements, I'll live. I'll be fine.
Maybe you misread the situation, Kim. Maybe he was just a very eco-conscious cat.
I don't know.
And felt that you were wasting and polluting and was angry.
No, I recycle all my goods. I recycle everything. So, you know.
Maybe you don't recycle enough, though. Maybe that's what he was trying to tell you.
All right.
Maybe
well, he did.
You need to do more.
Maybe. But like later on, I went up to my bedroom. My bedroom faces kind of the main street. And I went to shut the curtain. And there he was. Like, and instantly, he looked up at me like he knew where I was.
Like in the window? Was it raining and was there like a flash of lightning and you just saw the baby face on the cat staring at you?
Yeah, and he had a little knife and everything and
oh shit, that's really creepy. Was he holding the knife in his paw or was it in his mouth?
It was in his mouth.
Like pirate style.
Like pirate style,
Oh man, now I'm just imagining like the Jolly Roger sort of like streaming above him with like a little pirate bandana and an eye patch and a baby face.
I don't know if you've ever read any Lovecraft stories, but in one of them, I can't remember the name of it, but basically there's a rat with a human's face on it, and it's this kind of, it's a person who's been turned into a rat by a witch. Lovecraft for you.
Jeez.
But there's a film of it, and it is the most disturbing image I've ever seen. If you just Google Brown Jenkins, that's the name of the rat human thing. This cat looks, I've taken to calling this cat Brown Jenkins cat. Like, honestly, I swear to God, Sips, if I die before the end of this year, please, can you send someone around this area to find this Brown Jenkins
cat? Can we just put up like a whole dome up around the area that you live in and just detonate the whole thing?
Maybe, so that might be the best solution.
We'll just try to like take it all out and hope that the cat is like somehow stuck under there at the time.
I would definitely recommend that.
That sounds bad. I'm not sure I like that.
No.
I don't know if I want to meet this cat.
No, you don't.
I mean, do you think this cat would be a good counter to like a life-size or like a human-sized raven? Or do you think, that would be like a fairly even matchup?
It would be a fairly even matchup. Like me and Uthgard, you know, fighting each other. A human-sized raven and Brown Jenkins' cat would be a pretty even fight.
Yeah, I would love to see the special abilities that would be used in that fight. Also, I would like to hear what that fight would sound like. I don't know, like...
Raging, screeching cat versus squawking raven.
Yeah, the sound of a fight is very important, isn't it? Like sometimes, like, I don't know if you've ever driven by like a bus depot and you just hear like the hum of buses and like horns honking and stuff like that, and you just imagine, I wonder if all those buses are just like in there having a fight. Like they're all fighting in there. You know, just like vrooming around and honking at each other and just like slamming into the side of each other and stuff.
Like having a destruction derby or
something. Yeah, that'd be cool, eh? Like a secret life behind the scenes.
Yeah.
You're just like driving by this bus depot and you just think, ah, fuck, you know, it's probably boring in there. It's just like buses, whatever. But like behind the scenes, they're all in there just like, fighting. And
stuff's
just like
going down.
A Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Shit, yeah. That'd be sweet.
Game of the year.
That was it,
so,
Kim. My top five. All my games.
All your games. Half of them not released in 2013. One of them not even released at all yet because it's still in beta. But yeah, that was emotional. That was a really good list.
Thanks, Kim. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining me, Sips. And I hope you have a very Merry Christmas.
You too. Merry Christmas to you and your baby-faced cat and ravens. And good luck with all that.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.